business, I sold hand-painted clothing. And it was very, it was hard, you know, and I was totally run out of business by NAFTA. I didn't know at the time that's what it was. It totally was.
Wow.
Would you like to come on up?
Thank you. I'm David Griggs. I wear a lot of hats, so if you know me as a Democratic Party activist, as a Sierra Club environmental activist. But lately I have been working together with Herb, and if he comes in, he can speak as well. Herb Keener of CWA. The Sierra Club in Texas has a very close partnership with labor, with the FL-CIO, and particularly with the local CWA union in what has been called as the Blue-Green Alliance. And so one of the things that we're working on is to try to defeat the TPP and other trade agreements of similar ilk. If you have followed this closely, many of you have, in addition to the labor concerns that Daryl mentioned, there's also some very secretive negotiations that went on for quite a while before this thing actually came out. And inside the agreement that we now know, because it's been made public, there are secret tribunals that can be held. There are certain groups and organizations that can get together within the TPP rubric and basically make decisions that do not necessarily favor the public or people who are victimized by environmental disasters and labor discrepancies as well. And so the problem with this, number one, is the way in which disputes are settled is something that we cannot allow to continue. And it's the same thing. We knew it. You know, all along that the secret stuff came out, that it would be bad, and it's as bad as we could have expected. You know, all these agreements like NAFTA and others have similar provisions. Not only that, there is they can sue basically governments that don't agree with them, and we've seen that in NAFTA. You know, finally the president comes out and denies the Keystone pipeline. And then we see TransCanada suing the United States for the loss of business opportunity for billions of dollars.
Yes.
Right, exactly. You know, it's like lost opportunity damage. Yeah. As if somehow we owed it to them, to have put in their pipeline.
Yeah.
So that's one thing. Another thing is the problem of the proliferation of the extraction of fossil fuels that will no doubt occur if this Trans-Pacific Partnership becomes the law. If you think now that there's a great proliferation of oil and gas development, just wait. Because here's what's going to happen. Right now we have restrictions on the export of liquefied natural gas. That will all change, and there will be such a demand for liquefied natural gas in other parts of the world that this craze to frack will continue. It's bad enough now. It's somewhat subdued because the price of fuel is down, but the future is bad. So those of you who are concerned about climate change need to understand that with the passage of the TPP, it's going to be a horrible effect on climate change, because we will continue to extract these fossil fuels from the ground, which will contribute to the CO2 to the atmosphere. So in addition to the serious labor concerns that Daryl mentioned, there are serious climate implications as well. So that's why we need to work together to try to kill them. Thanks.